The Army's trying to find a new way to fight, and that's multi-domain operations. But to make multi-domain operations work, they have to have artificial intelligence, they have to have data collection, they have to connect all of these existing sensors, platforms, and shooters, to even to future ones that are going to be built in years from now. And part of that is Project Convergence. Project Convergence is essentially putting all that together, converging those assets to make them work, make them shoot what the Army wants, when it wants, where it wants, and how it wants. But that's a few years away. They're still developing that slowly, incrementally. Maybe by 2028, 2035, perhaps, they'll have that kind of fully integrated and to full fruition. But right now, a program called Scarlet Dragon is looking at a piece of that puzzle. Essentially, the 18th Airborne Corps, the unit that pretty much handles all the Army's airborne assets, think the 82nd Airborne Division or the 101st Airborne Division, they're at the, kind of the tip of the spear with this. They are the global response force, so they have to be in theater within a matter of hours or days, and they're trying to get those tools into the hands of those paratroopers so should they come on ground in theater, they can use them effectively. And to do that, Scarlet Dragon is essentially linking up the Army with the Marines, the Navy, the Air Force, and all their different assets. They've had, you know, 3 test fires up until recently. They had their 4th test fire in October. That included all those assets I just mentioned off the east coast of the United States at Fort Bragg and also in Nevada. So they went across the continental United States to make that happen. Eventually it'll be in theater in paratroopers' hands when they have to deploy one day. Right now the testing though is going through those different paces, figuring out how to make those systems talk to each other, make machines talk to machines, make those things work rapidly to get the data they need, when they want it, where they want it, so they can shoot what they need to. And they're going to need a system like that to fight peer competitors in the future. I'm Todd South with Military Times.